In this video, we will discuss linear data structure using sequential organization. In this video, we will consider about the ordered list. So, concept of ordered list. Ordered list is nothing but a set of elements. Such a list sometimes called as a linear list. Here, these are the two examples of a ordered list. List of one digit numbers. So, here 0 to 9. So, this is the one set of elements. This is called as an ordered list. Then days in a week, Sunday, Monday, up to Saturday. So this is the collection of elements. So here, these are the two examples of ordered list. An ordered list is a set of elements where set may be empty or it can be written as a collection of elements such as A1, A2, up to AN. Here, these are the few operations on ordered list. So here, first one is display. Another one is searching a element. Then third one, insertion of any element in a list. And last one is the deletion of any element in a list. Ordered list can be implemented using the list in a Python. So here, for Python programming, we will use list as an ordered list. Okay. So here, these are the few operations which are performed on the list in Python programming. First one, it is called as append. So append is nothing but the adding element at the end of a list. So this append function, it will add element at the end of a function. So here, if let us consider A as shown here, A is equal to 10, 60, 20, 80, 30, 90, 40, which is the example given here of A. Here we can append element into list by using function A.append and into bracket variable. So here a dot append, it will add element at the end of a list. Similarly, there is another function which is called as extend. So extend and append, these are the two functions which are used to update list. Append add element at the end, while extend add list at the end of old list. It will add list at the end of a list. So it will add multiple elements at the end. Next one, which is called as a sort. The sort method arranges the element in increasing order. So here sort function, it will organize all the element in increasing order. But here one condition is that if the list consists similar type of a data means either integer or character, then we can apply the sort. If the list is combination of integer and strings, we cannot apply sort operation on such a list. The next one, insert. We can insert element at the given position. And example of insert is insert index element. So we will put element at the given index. The next one, which is called as a delete. So for delete operation, we can use pop. We can use pop item. We can use remove. In case of pop, remove, delete, pop, it will remove element at a last element of the list. It will remove last element of the list. Then delete element, the deletion of any element from the list is carried out using various functions like pop, remove, delete, where pop, it will remove element which is present at the last. While delete, it will remove the function which is parameter which is given in with this function. So here delete, we have to write del and into bracket parameter. So here this will remove the given parameter. And last one, which is called as a remove. Remove function does not return any value. The execution of remove function is like only removing the element. But pop and delete, it will remove the element and it will return removed value to the called function. Correct. So this is the difference between pop, remove and delete. Here example is given where pop, remove, delete, a dot pop, where it will delete element at a given index. A dot pop, by default it will remove element at the last. Then a dot remove 20, here it will remove actual element which is given in the list. And delete a into square bracket 2:2:4 means it will remove list of elements. So multiple elements, which is nothing but the we are deleting from 2, 3, 4, these three elements. So these are some operations which are performed on the list. There are again few operations which are called as all, any, length, max, mean, sum and sorted. This function they are used to perform operation on list, where there is a difference between sort and sorted. The sorted, this function returns a list which is sorted one, correct? So similarly here we can use sort or sorted. Then there is another concept which is called as a list comprehension. List comprehension is an intelligent way to create and define new list using existing list. This is mainly useful to make a new list where each element is obtained by applying some operations on each member of another sequence. So such a type of method is called as a list comprehensive. Okay, so we will stop here.